How are you guys doing? Today is Thursday, July 1st, 2021. I'm James Sims, and for this episode of The Elite, I'm going to do an elite individual profile on Charlie Blackmon. The elite outfielder for the Colorado Rockies turns 35 today, and with this episode, I'm just going to go through all the stats, figures, achievements, accolades that he's been able to achieve from the moment he stepped out into the main stage up until now, to give a sense of why, out of all the baseball players, he is listed as one of the elite. So just getting right into it, Charlie Blackmon's originally out of Dallas. He would get recruited to come play at Georgia Tech in Atlanta. In 2008, at the age of 22, he was selected by the Colorado Rockies in the amateur draft, and he would eventually get called up for the Colorado Rockies in 2011 as a 24-year-old. In his 2011 campaign, he would go on to play 27 games in a season where the Colorado Rockies would finish with a 73-89 record. They won 10 less games than the previous season, and Charlie Blackmon rarely played. In the 27 games he played, he finished with 25 hits and 9 runs, and maybe with one home run and 8 RBIs, batting .255 and holding a .573 OPS. Of course, the man wasn't an all-star. He would come back in 2012 for his age 25 season, as he was yet another player that was competing for a roster spot. In 2012, he would play 42 games in a season where the Rockies would finish with a 64-98 record. They had won 9 less games than the previous season, just to show how much they regressed. In the 42 games he played, Blackmon finished with 32 hits, only 15 runs, with a .283 batting average and .732 OPS, as he was becoming more consistent, but of course, all of it wasn't there yet. His third season in Colorado was 2013, his age 26 season. In that season, he would play half the games, 82, as he was still fighting for a roster spot. He played half the games in a season where the Rockies would finish with a 74-88 record. They finished with the worst record in the National League West for the second year in a row, but they won 10 more games than the previous season. In this season, Charlie Blackmon would finish with 76 hits in 82 games. Yet another season where he had less hits than innings played, but he was becoming much more consistent with his hitting. He would finish with a .309 batting average and an .803 OPS. He had less hits than games played. He would go on to finish with 35 runs in those 82 games as well, with 17 doubles, showing that he was very on pace to put together a very good statistical season. Following his third season in Colorado, Charlie Blackmon would finally break through in his fourth year in Denver. In his age 27 season, he would become a full-time starter, playing 154 games for a Colorado Rockies team that would finish 66-96 with 8 less wins than the previous season. In 2014, Charlie Blackmon would become an all-star for the very first time in his career. After starting for a full season for the very first time in his career, he would finish with 171 hits in 154 games, he would finish with 82 runs on the season, all of which career highs. He finished with 27 doubles, the first time he ever eclipsed 20 doubles. He had 19 home runs, the most home runs he hit at that point in his career, 72 RBIs, the same, and then he finished with 28 stolen bases, the first time he even got double-digit stolen bases. Overall, he finished with a .288 batting average and .775 OPS, and he was named an all-star for the very first time in his career in his very first season as a complete starter. Following that, he would come back to Colorado for his fifth season in 2015. His age 28 season, he would go on to play 157 games in a season where the Colorado Rockies would go on to finish with a 75-87 record. They would win 7 more games than the previous season and still completely miss the playoffs. In 2015, they would end up going 68-94. They won 2 more games in the previous season. But going back, he would go on to play 150. He played 157 of those games. He finished with 176 hits. The second season, he eclipsed the 162 hit mark, which is the amount of games in a season. He would go on to finish with 31 doubles, the first time he eclipsed 30 doubles in a season. He had 17 home runs alongside 58 RBIs. He finished with 43 stolen bases, the most stolen bases that Charlie Blackmon has ever put up in his career. He would finish with a .287 batting average over the season with a .797 OPS, And even though he didn't make an All-Star game, he was most definitely one of the reasons why the Rockies, well, he was one of the main contributors for a Rockies team that was still sitting at the bottom of their division. Following his fifth season in Colorado, he would come back in 2016 for his age 29 season. He would play 143 games in a season where the Rockies would win seven more games in the previous season. They finished with a 75-87 record, the record I said earlier, but it actually went to 2016. They would miss the playoffs yet again, and in this season, in this season, Charlie Blackmon would finish with 187 hits in 143 games, which is a difference of 44 more hits than games played. He would still not go on to make the All-Star team, but of course, he was still showing why he was one of the best. He would finish with 35 doubles on the season, which up until that point was a career high, and the second straight year where he had at least 30 doubles. He had 5 triples. The previous season, he had 9. He had 29 home runs against 82 RBIs. In both those statistical categories, those were career highs. He finished with 17 stolen bases, finishing with a .324 batting average. This is the first full season he's played in where he's finished with a .300, and this the second year in the league in which he finished with a .300 batting average. He finished with a .933 OPS, which is the highest he'd ever put up in a season. And following the season, he would go on to be named a Silver Slugger. And at the end of the day, even though he was an MVP, he was found 26th in voting in a season where Chris Bryant would be named the MVP right before the Cubs, or right before the Cubs really went on and won the World Series. Following that season, following two straight seasons in which Charlie Blackmon put up All-Star numbers and was not named an All-Star, he was named an All-Star for the second time in 2017 in his age 30 season, his seventh year with the Colorado Rockies. He would play 159 games in a season where the Rockies would finish with an 87-75 record. They won 12 more games than the previous year, and they would go on to make the National League Wild Card game. In Charlie Blackmon's second All-Star campaign, he would finish with 213 hits in 159 games. That is the only time in his career he's eclipsed 200 hits. This would be the fourth year in a row he's topped at least 170, by the way, which is a crazy amount of hits for a season. He would finish with 137 runs as he led the National League in runs scored. He led the league in plate appearances with 725 for the only time in his career. He will go, and like I said, this would be his only batting title, or the only time in his career he's actually led the entire league in hits. He would finish with 35 doubles, which is the fourth time he eclipsed the 20 mark, and he's eclipsed the 30 mark, tied for his career high. He would finish with 14 triples, which led the National League, the only time he's led the National League in triples. He'd finish with 37 home runs, the most home runs he's ever put up in a season to date. He finished with 104 RBIs, also the most RBIs he's ever put up in a season to date. He would go on to finish with a .331 batting average, which was the batting title. He was home runs away from winning the MVP. And alongside his National League leading .331 batting average, he'd finish with a 1,000 OPS, finishing with them, and he led the entire National League in total bases. And he would be named in addition to being named an All-Star for the second time, he was named a Silver Slugger for the second year in a row. And after leading the league in hits, triples, and batting average alongside runs and total bases, in 2017, Charlie Blackmon would finish fifth in National League voting at the conclusion of the season. And of course, going into the playoffs, they would end up losing in the National League wild card to the Diamondbacks within their own division. Following the 2017 season, he would come back in 2018 for his age 31 season with Colorado. At this point, his eighth season on the team. In his age 31 season, he would play 156 games in a season where the Rockies would go on to finish with a 91-72 record, 4 more wins than the previous season. Within this year, Blackmon would be named an All-Star for the second year in a row and for the third time in his career. In the 156 games he played, he would finish with 182 hits. This would be the fifth season in a row in which he's finished with at least 170 hits, which when you consider that an MLB season is 162 games is a very ridiculous thought, considering he's not playing all 162 games, but I digress. Along with his 182 hits, he would go on to lead the National League in runs for the second year in a row. He finished with 119 runs. This would be the third straight season where he finished with at least 100 runs. And ever since he's been a full-time starter, this is the sixth season since he's been a full-time starter in which he's registered at least 80 runs on a season. He finished with 42 doubles, which is the most doubles that, or he finished with, I'm sorry, in 2018, he finished with 31 doubles that season. He finished with 21 home runs alongside 71 RBIs, posting a .291 batting average alongside an .860 OPS. At the conclusion of the season, once they made the playoffs, they would go on to beat the Cubs in the National League Wild Card Series and lose in the National League Division Series to the Brewers. And this is the season in which the Red Sox actually beat the Dodgers, just for a little bit of background. But that's actually the furthest that Charlie Blackmon has made it in the playoffs with the Rockies, is to the second round. And not to mention, in 2018, Charlie Blackmon did go on to hit for the cycle towards the end of the season. Following the 2018 season, this leads us into 2019, the last full season of the MLB that was completed before COVID. In the 2019 season, Charlie Blackmon would be named an All-Star for the third year in a row as he played 140 games for a Colorado Rockies team that would finish with a 71-91 record. They had lost, or they had won 20 less games than the previous season. And like I said, they completely missed the playoffs. And the Rockies have not made the playoffs since 2018. In the 140 games he would play, he finished with 182 hits, which is exactly the amount of hits he had in 2018. But in 2019, he played 16 less games. He would go on to finish with 42 doubles, which is the most amount of doubles he's ever had in a season in his career. He's only eclipsed 40 doubles one time in his career. He was able to finish with 32 home runs, the second most amount of home runs he's ever hit in his career, and 86 RBIs, the second most RBIs he was ever able to post. He finished with a .314 batting average, which up until this point is the third .300 season he's had since he's been a full-time starter for the Rockies, alongside a .940 ERA in addition. And this was the last time that he was ever named an All-Star, and to this date, he is still a four-time MLB All-Star. Continuing on to 2020, the season that was definitely impacted by COVID, just for a little bit of context, just to summarize it in a couple of sentences, the MLB season is normally 162 games, and because they had to delay the start by a few months because of COVID, the MLB decided to shorten the season to 60 games, where every team had to play within their own division, I believe. Or they had to play like within their side. If it's NL East, you had to play against the AL East and then your own division as well. Same with the Central and the West. And they also expanded the playoff to include 8 teams on both sides to make up for the lack of games being played. In 2020, Charlie Blackmon would play 59 of the Colorado Rockies' 60 games in a season where they would finish with a 26-34 record and still miss the playoffs, even though they expanded it. In the 2020 season, in the 59 games he played, he finished with 67 hits, yet another season in which he's been able to place contact on the ball and do whatever he really could. At the same time, he was able to finish with 12 doubles in those 60 games, which is a double every 5 games. He finished with 6 home runs, 42 RBIs. He finished with a .300 batting average. This would be, up until this point, the fifth season in his career in which he was able to finish the season with a .300 batting average, alongside an .804 OPS. And like I said, they didn't make the playoffs. And that would lead us into Charlie Blackmon's current season, 2021, his age 34 season, in which he just turned 35 today. Thus far, he's played 76 games for a Colorado Rockies team that's sitting with the fourth best record in the National League West, very far out of the playoff picture. But of course, at the end of the day, they're not out until they're out. In the 76 games he's played, he has 66 hits, which is less hits than games played for the time being. Not off to the best start to his career. He's batting .260 at the moment alongside a .732 OPS. At the moment, he has 32 runs in the 76 games he's played. grade alongside 12 doubles, a couple of triples, four home runs, and 38 RBIs. And right now, yeah, this leads us to where we are exactly with Charlie Blackmon. And even though this season they might not do incredibly well, Charlie Blackmon himself might not do incredibly well. But I don't think this season should distract many people, many baseball viewers from the streak of excellence he's had as a batter since the moment he became a full-time starter in 2014 as a 27-year-old up until now. He's been a player that has gotten better with age and is one of the most consistent hitters in baseball that not that many people talk about, but in this episode, I'm going to talk about it. So once again, I want to thank Wikipedia, I want to thank the baseball reference websites, MLB.com, ESPN, for all the facts and figures to help me do this. I want to thank everyone for listening 12-15 minutes of this piece. I hope all is well. I want to wish Charlie Blackmon a happy 35th birthday. And with that said, if you ever get a chance to watch him, he's wearing number 19 for the Rockies. And like I said, if you do watch a Rockies game, the Rockies are more than likely going to lose, but you'll probably see Charlie Blackmon doing something, which is really kind of the point of it all. With that said, thanks once again. Today is Thursday, July 1st, and we go through a full year, I hopefully plan on making another episode this time next year. But until then, thanks for listening to my piece, and peace out. I'll catch you with another episode tomorrow.